Hey everyone, and welcome back to Spiritfarer. Last time we had our first big D&D session with Buck as our game master, and that apparently led to us getting our last ability, the Light Burst, or what I'm going to assume now is the last ability. It was a mystery, since if you recall, at some episode, I didn't actually go back and check, but at some episode, I still believe it was in regards to those ectoplasm things that they suggested. Someone suggested we should use our Light Burst, which I honestly had no idea what was. Now we do. Today, we are going to light the fires of Tondor, and we can actually see it there in the background. They are lighthouses. We are going to light three of them to continue Buck's questline. And we also have Jackie's questline that he now finally realized he would actually like to have a house. Francis just happened to show up here as I reloaded the game, which is pretty nice. So let's go ahead and talk with him. He clearly has something to say. I got a favor to ask. Yes, me, a favor. How odd it must be for you. Nobody must ask you for favors on that giant boat of yours. Listen, as a wandering merchant, I'm always looking for the next customer. I can't really do the simple things in life. I always need to be ready. Now, I have an important errand for you. I need you to go get my groceries. I know, I just can't live off fish and seagulls for eternity. Go have a look. My grocery list might seem strange to you. I assure you, it's very common where I'm from. Okay. A greasy spoon. It's nothing. I don't think this is not new. This is expensive. 2 diamonds and 5 electrum sheets. Not cheap. Oh, I hope that treasure map is worth it. What else do we have? Did I miss it? I don't see anything new. That's Elena's demand. It must be this one then. Saturday night shopping list, I guess. That's something. Okay, I'll think about it, my friend. I'll think about it. Is it actually a? No, it's not. Ooh, right, we still have to talk to the doctor back in Overbrook. Well, for now, let's get lighting. What? That there is a bee icon, which I'm guessing means there is honey ready for us. Well, we'll have to wait a little bit. Wonder if this ability can be used for something other than this. Very nice. Wonder if it's gonna do something. Maybe on the map even. Do you have anything interesting? You have pork, why not? You have an opal. Not really. Okay. Doesn't look like it does anything special. That's completely fine. The next one... We're gonna go talk to Buck after this. It's the North Sea Pier, and we have the Sandwich Walk. Ooh, the Sandwich Walk. I remember that, but where was it? Was it down here in the new one? I don't think so. We have the North Sea Pier that we need to go to. Yes, that's another one. A Sandwich Walk. There it is. Okay. Well, bus stop time it is. Oh, he's up here. Excellent. You did it, Commander. The first fire has been lit, and you can hear the hopeful chants of the free people from afar. Your worth is grander than the mightiest arm of Rukthador the Paladin. The moonbirds of Wa'iran will soon sing your praises in all the languages of Romalda. But, Commander, as bright our moment of joy can shine, we have to remain vigilant. Gumgota and his lackeys will probably be alerted by the sight of this glorious fire. And lurking in the branches. Roll initiative. Ooh, 15. We were better this time. Great. Amidst the squalor of the exotic foliage, you can clearly decipher a group of orcs and goblins progressing towards your encampment. Getting closer. Springing from their retreat, they jump on you. Fight. Okay, well. Now we know which ones to go for. Don't know if we actually need to do these as well to get a higher chance to spawn some of the real ones, but seemed like none of them were spawning, so might as well get some of them done. Ah, come on. I like this event. I think this has been great fun. I like the whole storyline of Buck. Okay. Let's go get some honey. Yoink. Just the one. Okay. Actually, let's do this. Let's plant something else. What would they like? Sugar canes? Sunflowers? Let's do some sunflowers, why not? I have no idea what they are. I mean, flowers, obviously, but we don't really have any, like, just flower seeds. Victory! The dust from what was an epic battle barely settles. Layers upon layers of evil carcasses litter the ground of the battlefield. You are exhausted, but once again, victorious. Make a perception check. 14. Well, that's okay. Success. As you observe your defeated enemies, you can only wonder where Gumgota lies. He is nowhere to be seen. His pathetic retreat doesn't surprise you. He is a follower of Gor-Nemloth, after all, and his cowardice is notable. Quick, let's ride post-haste. The next fire awaits. Onwards. It does indeed. And Alex is here to help us in that matter. This one? Yes, it is. Now, I guess since we're here, we should stop by Susan. She's not our biggest fan, but don't necessarily think we really need to anymore. But since we are so close, let's see what we have accomplished since we were here last time. No, actually on the way there, why don't we see what it requires to build Jackie's home? Because that is the last house we need to build. We need some pine planks, that we can do. That we can do, we can do a few of those. And a few is probably honestly all we need. I don't think I've done any of these on camera, so. They do get more and more tricky, but honestly I find with these ones, with this particular minigame, the less you have to wait around and suddenly move, like with the first ones, honestly the easier it becomes. When it's constantly moving, for me, it's easier to control. Huh. Hey, Susan, our favorite character. Hello. What do you want? Get on with it already. Yes, you're very bored. Right, it's collections. Okay. Nothing there yet. Nothing there yet either. That one is finished. Ooh, we can claim a reward here. Okay. Here we are again. Still going strong with the ingots. My hands are literally tied by my profession. I have to accept the trash you bring me. What is it now? Your pocket's full of ingots. Remember to take them out before you go swimming. Here's a little something to show you I care. Not about you, but the act of showing that I care. Well, got a new outfit. That's nice. Anything here? Yeah. Ooh, 5 honey. Look at you. You're still making dishes. Good for you. You should never give up, even when people say you're bad at it. And believe me, people are talking about your bad cooking. Bye. Well. Bye. Onwards to North Sea Pier. But first, before we build a house, very, very importantly, that's not the home. This is the home. We, of course, gonna switch to the Twilight outfit. I wonder if it's the... It's not the tux, is it? It's probably Dusty? That's with the Twilight? Yeah. I believe that we had the tux before. Okay, a little bit of darkness as we settle towards the end here, I guess. Can you fit in there? Ah, just about not. That's fine. It's looking beautiful, I know. What do you need to improve it? We can't. Interesting. That's what he said he needed. 4 walls and a place to sleep. I guess that's what you get. I'm sure he'll want just a teensy tiny bit more. But for now, let's go and light another Tower of Tondor. They called them Tower, right? Fires of Tondor, of course. I thought that was something a bit off. That might be... This one would be faster. Nice. I completely forgot to check if there's anything we need here, but let's assume that there's not really. And okay, it actually just just ends in nothing out there. Okay, well, then I guess there's nothing at the other end there. Okay, everyone probably has something to say right now. Let's, meanwhile, though, head... Really? You still have something? Well, I think one visit to Susan per episode is enough. Superb! Oh, we are gonna have an event after this, so let's talk to Jackie first. You actually did it! And it's, very... Yeah, well, it's pretty much exactly what I asked for, right? Yes, it is, my friend. I guess I just didn't expect it all to be so... drab. Not that I mind. You should have seen some of the places I've lived. In comparison, this looks like a 5-star hotel. But, like, more boring. But in a good way. Boring like meditation or reading. Zen, is that a word? Anyway, thanks a bunch. I'll be able to assist you much better with this little on-call room. Okay, so nothing so far. Well, let's talk to Buck then. As the second fire of Tondor is lit, clamors of exultation spread throughout the vast expanses of the kingdom. The Chosen One has arrived. She who bears the light will help us all. Glory to the commander. Glory to Halor. Your heart lifted by such grandiose acclamation, your soul irradiates with serenity, but your mind remains watchful and perceptive. You know that, stirred by an upheaval that marks their near demise, the orcs of the Shadowsteel clan must be closing on your position. And, lo and behold, roll initiative. Ooh, a natural 20. Critical. Without a moment of hesitation, you jump into the fray, taking by surprise the approaching phalanx of orc fighters. You ready yourself to mow through them with deftness and style. Fight. Okay. Let's get ourselves some XP potions, shall we? Can't get to that one. Can't get to that one, though. That one is gonna disappear, yep. Get that one. Maybe two? Yeah, beautiful. I was close to not being able to do that, I think. It was close to disappearing, but we got it, luckily. Oh, my lip is itchy. And pause, though. Well, we probably can, but in the midst of a battle. Wonder how close we actually need to be to them to get it. That might have been right on the edge there, to be honest. Yeah, okay, so we need to be kind of close, that's fair. That makes sense. That's the last one, probably, sounds like it. Yeah, okay. That was good enough, I think. What are these? Okay, I just want to... Let's travel before we go anywhere else. Before we talk to anyone. That one? Yes, we are right there. Because this music is indeed driving me nuts. Let's talk to Buck. What a fight! They didn't stand a chance. What remains of their shattered dark armors is promptly blown away by the swift northern wind. Commander, you are victorious once again, and this time Gongota couldn't oppose your strength and was heroically slain. The orcs of the Shadowsteel clan shall henceforth dread your might, Commander. Cunning they will have to prove to even attempt to find you. But let's not dawdle a second more. Your goal is within your grasp, Commander. Let's set sail again onto the ultimate fire of Tondor. Ouch. Are you getting stung by the bees? What the hell? Stella, I didn't do nothing wrong, all right? It was these gosh darn little psycho critters. They just lashed out at me. Bunch of lunatics. I'm caring for you all, all right? You'll be dead if I didn't care for you. I should just pump him full of smoke and dump him off the boat. The bees. Shit. I'm doing it again, aren't I? It's Daria all over again. They're just bees. They can't do anything wrong. And Daria, she's just Daria. I don't know why I get like that, Stella. Sometimes something happens. Anything. A big noise. Someone says something I don't like. Or has got an attitude. Has a bad attitude. And I just get so overwhelming. It feels like I'm drowning and I don't breathe and I can't think. I just start seeing red and then I barely remember what happened. I want to change, Stella. You gotta believe me, please. I don't know how. I thought I could do it by myself, but obviously... Yeah, I'm a chump. I know it. Jackie the loser. Don't think I haven't heard that one before. Can't do anything right. Always messing up. Just I need some time alone. I can't talk to you right now. This is Gwen all over again. She was kind of she was sad as well. She needs to figure some things out too. That's one too many down. No need to go into the water. Let's go get the last fire of Tondor. Kinda remember. Ooh, it's actually right here. I thought it was to the right. Nice. This is one crazy place. Hey, Buck. You like hanging out up here for some reason. At last, the world erupts in elation. All the fires have been lit. Tondor has arisen. The Lich-God Gor-Nemloth is on the verge of being defeated once more. But what is it? What is this terrible ruckus you hear? 1,000 warhorns roar at once. Could it be? Fatefully, yes. The final assault of the Shadow Steel Clan, led by One-Eye Umgarthog himself. Clad in the eldritch armor of Rungmar, Umgarthog points his loathsome blade at you. You won't escape me this time, you miserable maggot. I will destroy you and the hopes of this world. Trembling in fear and apprehension, you gather your inner strength to face the enemy. Make a courage check. Ooh, 18. We don't care. The orc won't scare you, for you are the Lightbearer, the Chosen One. Now the time has come for you to show them what you are made of. Fight. Okay. It's kind of odd, but I think, honestly, this is probably the most fun I've had in Spiritfarer. Yeah, we're not gonna get that one. That's okay. We'll get the next one. But, you know, I'm a big fan of tabletop, so I guess that makes sense. Ooh, nice. It's good to know that we don't need to like hug them as much as I have been doing, at least. Wonder if maybe killing or whacking the normal ones maybe somehow extends the event. I would be surprised. It hasn't been like that with the others, so. Okay. Okay, Jackie has something to say as well. Get some honey first, though. Let's talk to Jackie first. Oh, he's starting to, okay, he lives like some young punk just moved out of, from mom and dad, that's for sure. Hey, Stella. We need to have a talk. I'm not doing good, Stella. Like, not at all. I know I act tough and all, but truth be told, I don't think I've ever been doing good. Shit. You know, you really do get on my nerves sometimes. Always so happy or caring, just sparkly. I don't know how you do it. I've seen those people you care for. I know them, cause I've cared for them too. And yeah, sure, some of them are nice and all. But most of them, pardon my language, they're assholes. I wonder if he's a colleague, maybe. From the hospital, or... from the hospice where we might have worked. Nitpicky, demanding, rude, but you, everything seems to just glide over you. Some old cuckoo tells you, yells at you cause their pudding's the wrong color, and you just smile softly, gently, always. And then you magically fix the situation. You're always the first to arrive, the last to leave. And I've never heard you bad-mouthing a patient. As for me, I need help, Stella. Whenever I try to get better on my own, I just wind up sliding back in a dark place. And I'm so sick of being angry all the time. I think it's time I stop kidding myself. I'm not a caretaker. I can't even take care of myself. So, you know, guess you have a new patient now. I'm sorry to be a burden like that. Not that I know of any other way to live. So, now that the hard thing's been said, my room, it's a little bare, don't you think? I want a fresh start, but I'm not sure a naked jail cell is the way to go. When I think of something, I'll just ask you straight. No games. For the moment, though, could you get me, like, some posters or something? I can't stand concrete walls anymore. I really need them covered up. I feel like I'm getting cabin fever in here. I'm almost at the make-a-girlfriend-out-of-mashed-potatoes point right now. Okay, well. Motivational posters. Unimaginable. Through the thick mist of the aftermath, silhouette is barely discernible against the terrifying backdrop of a gargantuan battle. All free people in the world are holding their breath, hearts pounding in their chests. A deafening silence creeps in, an atmosphere thick as rock. Victory! The Chosen One has triumphed. She who bears the light has conquered. In a crackling sound of terror, Gor-Nemloth's shadow stops immediately its course over the darkened sky. The Lich-God is no more. May the Radiant Fae bless our souls. May Halor forever watch over your path. May the graces of Imalda sing our praises for eons to come. The world is saved, and now, jaded but jolly, the hero stands up once more. Looking at the horizon, her heart fills with hope, her resolve stronger than ever. A chapter of the adventures might be completed, but her story is far from over. Rejoice, free people of the world, for the Chosen One will be back. But for now, she will rest her heavy shoulders, unload her burden, and once more gaze at the stars. Hot damn, I'm tired. Congrats, you did it, Stella. Okay, now if you don't mind, I need to take a break. I'll take some time to think about what great adventure we could do next. A space opera with lasers and spaceships. A post-apocalyptic road war setting. Or a horrific eldritch adventure with cosmic horrors, maybe. We'll see. Well, very nice. I'm guessing, though, maybe it's time to take Buck to the Evador. Okay, a clear glass sheet and a bronze sheet. Well, I guess we can do that. Bronze and clear glass, yes. Before we do that, can we upgrade it? Can't remember if we needed something else. Steel sheet and gold ingots. You know what? Let's for the last bit of the episode here. Let's do some good old crafting here. It's been a while since we used this one. Hopefully we have some gold. Oh, we have tons of gold. Tons of gold. But the problem with gold is that it is so slow to melt. I really dislike the ones where you have to wait like this outside of the melting point. But that's how some of them are. Luckily we don't need too many, and the upgrade is great. Let's do the steel sheet then. Mostly because I have no idea what it's gonna do to this one. It might just be, you know, like with some of the other ones, that it's literally it might just increase the output. But yeah. I would love if it would make it automatic, but that's wishful thinking. That is at least enough to upgrade this one. Boom. Nice. Okay, let's go find out what it does then. We needed a clear glass and a bronze, if I do remember correctly, and hopefully I do. But we don't do anything extra that we don't need to up here in this one. Bronze is right there. I think the hammer goes down or cools off a little bit faster, but maybe it's just wishful thinking. Let's see if we get two. We do. Okay. That's pretty nice. It's still pretty nice. Not exactly maybe what I would have wanted, but it's still pretty nice. It's still pretty nice. It's a little bit late to the party, but I guess we can thank ourselves for that because we didn't get Buck early on. Yeah, no, it's not cooling down any faster. Yeah, that would have been a huge upgrade in the beginning if we had found Buck much, much early on. Just getting two of each is very, very nice. What were we doing? We were upgrading his Jackie's home, right? Yeah. Let's get that one going. That's very nice. And I think, yeah, that's where we're gonna put a... That's where I'm gonna end the episode today. So, I would have loved to actually end the series here, because I think if everything goes according to plan, next week we will be playing some Frostpunk 2. I did just go ahead and buy that one today because I absolutely love Frostpunk. It's not the game we usually play on the channel, or the kind of game we usually play on the channel, but we did play Frostpunk 1, and I absolutely love that game. It's by far one of my... It's in the top of my all-time favorite games. I absolutely love it. I've played it several times. It never gets dull. So I very much want to play some Frostpunk 2 on the channel as well. And I think next week we'll be checking that out, and then we'll be back with Spiritfarer the week after that again. And I don't know, of course, but judging by where we are, it seems like we're getting pretty close to the end here. So probably the last week, which is why I would have loved to end it instead of put in a break like that. But that's okay. That's okay. Stuff like that happens. But next time we will continue with these missions. We need to talk to Jackie, and we hopefully Buck will have something to say as well. Thank you so much for watching, and until next time, take care.